Angry students and faculty members of the Ateneo de Manila University hold a protest Tuesday, October 15, after another case of sexual harassment involving a faculty member surfaced on Facebook Monday night. The post was from a student who alleges a female professor from the English department inappropriately touched him and threatened to fail him after. The student also claims the professor harassed four other victims, two of whom were fellow faculty members. He says the investigation was delayed for 6 months, and when the decision came out, the English professor was only given a 15-day suspension. In a statement, the university says it does not, quote, tolerate or condone sexual harassment by any member of its community. Due process is followed, all parties are heard, and justice is served. University President Father Jet Villarin also announces the drafting of an anti-sexual harassment manual to be completed by the end of 2019. But this is not the first time a sexual harassment case sparked outrage in the Ateneo community. In October 2018, the Ateneo Student Council filed a case against a longtime male instructor who allegedly sexually harassed several students. But there have been no developments on the case since then. The Armed Forces of the Philippines, or AFP, says it favors the lifting of martial law in parts of Mindanao, particularly Davao City. AFP spokesperson Edgar Arevalo says the selective lifting is based on the recommendation of Davao City Mayor and presidential daughter Sara Duterte. Mindanao has been under martial law since May 2017, when the pro-ISIS multi-terror group laid siege to Marawi City. The imposition was repeatedly extended by Congress upon the insistence of the Duterte administration, citing security threats from terrorists and communist insurgents. Congress will decide again whether to extend martial law in Mindanao before it expires at the end of 2019. Hong Kong Chief Executive Carrie Lam abandons a State of the Union-style speech Wednesday, October 16, after she is heckled by opposition lawmakers inside the city's legislature. Lam's speech was supposedly an attempt to win hearts and minds after 4 months of intense pro-democracy protests in the city. Lam then left the building and her office announced she would release a pre-recorded video of the speech instead. It is the first time in Hong Kong's history a chief executive is unable to deliver the annual address in person since the tradition began in 1948. Meanwhile, the U.S. House of Representatives passes the Hong Kong Human Rights and Democracy Act Tuesday, October 15. The bill will end the Hong Kong U.S. special trading status unless the U.S. State Department certifies annually that city authorities are respecting human rights and the rule of law. It will now move to the U.S. Senate before it can become law. The internet breaks as actress Jennifer Aniston opens an Instagram account and her friend's co-stars were there when she posted for the first time. Aniston, known for playing Rachel Green in the hit sitcom, posts on Tuesday, October 15, a photo with co-stars Lisa Kudrow, Courtney Cox, Matt LeBlanc, David Schwimmer, and Matthew Perry. Friends is a story of a group of six young adults living in New York City and ran from 1994 to 2004. It is considered by many to be one of the most memorable television shows in recent history. Actress Chris Aquino and her former business manager Nico Falsis have, quote, fairly settled all financial issues and amicably worked out all personal differences. In an Instagram post, Aquino says, learn from yesterday, like today, but above all, make sure to love tomorrow. Aquino and Falsis were embroiled in a legal battle since October 2018. Aquino filed a qualified theft complaint against Falsis in seven cities, alleging misuse of the corporate card she gave him as managing director of Aquino's production company. Falsis later filed a grave threats case against Aquino in January 2019 after a threat in a phone conversation while Aquino was abroad.